When some people meet Ian Simpson for the first time, they look at his wheelchair and ask him, what happened to you? He'll say, well, there was the Paralympics, wheelchair rugby, a teaching career. Not exactly the answer they expect, but it's all true. Let's welcome Ian to Studio 10. Ian, you field a lot of questions. Some of them drive you crazy. What are they?
Well, that's one of them. What happened to you? In fact, that's probably the golden oldie. So, as you say, I like to put a positive spin on it, on the book. And that's why the cover says, you know, Paralympics, wheelchair rugby, things like that. And so hopefully I'm turning a negative into a positive.
What was it like representing Australia at Paralympics?
Well, it was a long time ago at the Paralympics. That was in 88 in Seoul. But so usually when in most disabled sports, you've performed before family and friends. The audience is about this size. We went out to the opening ceremony at Seoul. There were 80,000 people there.
Wow.
And we were just blown away.
Mm.
And apparently that's the first Paralympics where they really sort of got behind it in a big way. And we all saw what it was like in Sydney.
Mm.
And it's been like that ever since.
They've actually been really good at making the Paralympics literally parallel to the Olympics. And I was there when it was in Sydney. It was amazing. Talk to me about wheelchair rugby, because it's called Murder Ball for a reason. It is just brutal. The things you guys put yourselves through. It's amazing.
Yeah.
No one comes off even worse than they went on.
Well, you saw some of the clips beforehand, and you can look at Riley Batt there now. And he's one of the more able guys.
Oh.
There you go.
It's like dodge 'em cars.
I had that a couple of times, so but you know, your head breaks the fall, so
yeah.
Oh,
but usually it's guys like Riley who get most of those big hits. We're trying to block for him and create space, a bit like American football.
In many respects, Ian, I guess you're lucky because you have represented Australia and achieved quite a lot. But for everyday people confined to wheelchairs, it's hard to get the message through that it's your achievements that probably more define you than, would you say, the chair? But people see the chair.
Well, that's why I sort of take issue slightly with the term confined to a wheelchair.
Yes.
Because, and again, I know it's just perception, but as I say, if it wasn't for the wheelchair, I really would be confined. The wheelchair is what gives me life.
Mm. What would you rather say?
Well, I talk about in the book about living in a wheelchair.
Mm. Okay.
So.
And how do you cope when people say those naive things to you? Do you try to ignore it, or do you find the time and the patience to actually explain a few things to them.
Well, I'm fairly open-minded about it, and I know that they're only being friendly, and you can't have enough of that.
Mm.
So it's just that I've been in a chair now for nearly 50 years, since the age of three.
I bet those were three when you became a quadriplegic.
Well, in 1969, no one really batted an eyelid if a three-year-old was in the front seat of a car and without a seatbelt.
Mm.
I mean, somebody did that nowadays, a parent, they'd be reported to docs.
Yeah.
But
what you've done with your life.
This was 50 years ago,
nearly. What you've done. You haven't let this stop you.
Thanks. Yeah. That's why I say I'm not confined to the
and
wheelchair.
And
the wheelchair that gives me
your wife is here.
And my wife is here.
Yeah.
Alison.
Hello, Alison.
This is a pretty interesting story about when you guys met and how it all unfolded with Alison's parents.
Yeah, well, we met at a wheelchair rugby tournament in Wellington, New Zealand. And a couple of days later, I'd come home, of course, and I went over to see her mum to have a cuppa and everything. And she said she'd met a guy on the weekend, and she said, and Al's mum, Sally, said, yeah, that's nice, that's good. And then Al said, and he was in the wheelchair rugby. And so Sally said, oh, he's a player, is he? He's in a chair. Oh, that's fine, that's good. And then she said, oh, it's just one more thing. He's an Australian. And Sally said, are you crazy? So I like that story because I think your wise audience here can probably work out the reason why. There was an acceptance there straight away.
That's great.
In fact, it extended to the rest of my in-laws. So.
Well, thanks for joining us today. We're looking forward to seeing the book. And if you're interested, and I'm sure you are, Ian Simpson's book is called Rolling with the Punches, and it's available now. So get to your book.
Thank you.
Thank you.